Hi friends, welcome to Shiva Teachable. So today's session we are going to discuss lab activity 1 of the first lesson, characteristics of an image from a spherical mirror. In this session, first in this lab activity we have to discuss aim of this lab activity. The aim of the lab activity is observing the types of images and measuring the object distance and image distance from the mirror. Say we know that this is the object distance. The distance from the mirror to the candle is called as object distance. The distance from the mirror to the screen is called as image distance. This one we are going to discuss in this session. For this, The material required are candle, paper as a screen, concave mirror, V stand, and meter scale or tape for measuring the distances. So coming to the procedure, the step one, place the concave mirror on V stand, a candle and a meter scale for this experiment. In the next step, keep the candle at the distance of 10 cm from the mirror. Means the distance from the mirror to the candle is 10 cm. In the next step, move the paper below the axis to find the position where a sharp image of the candle flame is formed. Make sure the candle flame above the axis. In this figure, you will able to observe that the image of the flame of candle is above the principal axis of mirror. Screen is always below the principal axis of the mirror. In the next step of procedure, note the distances of the image formed on the paper from the center of the mirror. Say, look here. Always we have to measure the distances from the center of the mirror, which is called as pole. Here we have to measure the distance from here to here, means the mirror to screen. So this is called as image distance. We have to note down this image distance on the paper. Next step. Repeat the procedure by changing the candle distance to 20 cm, 30 cm, 40 cm, 50 cm, like that, 80 cm, etc. So, when we are doing this experiment by changing the candle distance, means that is object distance, we will get different image distances respectively. In observations, by the different object distances which we take from 10 cm, 20 cm, 30 cm, like that, we have to note down here in the table. And also, we are getting different image distances. That's when we have to note down in the table here. And by observing the images which are formed on the screen, we have to write the size of the image here, whether it is enlarged. If the image is bigger, we have to write enlarged. If the image is smaller, we have to write diminished. In the next step, if the image is straight, we have to write erected. If the image is reversed, then we have to write inverted. Table is used to note down the observations as distance of candle from mirror, distance paper from mirror, size of the image and inversion of the image. All this information we have to note down in this table. In the next step, by observing and recording all the information in the lab activity, we can able to fill this table by the information. Position of the object between the mirror and focus. If the object is placed between the mirror and focus, the position of the image is behind the mirror or on the mirror. image size is bigger. Inversion is erected. It is a virtual image. When we keep the object on focal point at infinite, bigger, inverted, and real image. When we keep the object between focus and center of curvature, the position of the image is behind center of curvature. The size of the image is bigger and inversion is inverted, which is a real image. When we keep the object on center of curvature, we also get the image on center of curvature. The size is same and which is an inverted image and a real image. And when we keep the object behind the center of curvature, we will get the image between focus and center of curvature, which is a smaller image, which is also called as diminished image, which is inverted and real image. So, note down the other characteristics like position of the image, size of the image, inversion, and type of the image in the table 2. And basing on these observations, now what we can inference from this lab activity? From this lab activity, we can infer that we have learned that image characteristics for different object distance in front of concave mirror. So from this, by changing the object distances, we are getting different image distances and also the different characteristics from the different object distances which are discussed in this activity. So children, I hope you understand this lab activity very well. So please watch, share, subscribe and like Shiva Teaching World.